Thank you very much for your kind invitation. The total amount of joint replacements has been increasing over the last years all over the world. We got such different realities, but we got common problems. We see that the national health systems always are running short from budget, and they're asking to have more surgeries and to improve results and decrease the rate of complications. In the private systems, they want to lower the prices, but also they want to have a low morbidity and a lower rate of complications. So we need to find some strategies to increase our results and to prevent complications. And many years ago, we started with the fast track. They started in Denmark. And we'll try to see any or different strategies to manage those patients. And we started 4 years ago in my country. So Faresa had also told that cost-effectiveness studies are to evaluate the benefits of these modalities are required. Always, we need to put the patient's safety first. Emmanuel Tipoint also find that when we see the constraints for a day-based practice for outpatient surgery, medical issues were the most important factors that prevent a patient to go on the first day of the surgery. So outpatient surgery has become the ultimate challenge, but we cannot harm by any way the patient's safety. So 4 years ago, we started to know which is the ground we are walking into when we started to a fast-track project. So we must know how the national health management policies, how the reimbursement strategies of the private providers, which budget programs we have, which kind of surgeries do we have on our hospital, national guidelines on specific medical conditions, and we must know the traditional aspects of the population related to joint replacement surgery and surgeons' belief. So what is my environment at that time? There were no reimbursement for joint replacement surgery as an outpatient procedure in my hospital. Waiting lists on the public side for the other side were between 5 to 10 years. Some surgeons still believe that they must keep the patient at least 10 days at the hospital. And we conducted a survey on my patients, almost 700 patients that received a total knee replacement for a 2 year period. And none of them wanted to go home the same day. They felt safer. They got better conditions than home at the hospital. They feared about complications treated at their home. And no one was discharged to a nursery facility. All they went home. No one get reimbursed if they go on the same day. And 30% of my patients are coming from other cities or other countries. So do we need to rush to go to an outpatient strategy model? So my issue is no. Major complications and fatal complications are always on the first 72 hours after surgery. Most of the patients are discharged to their home, and they don't want to go home on the first day. Always, we need to think first on the patient's safety, and we don't need to be hyped to become good surgeons. So when you see the background, we see in the 1983 in the USA, they start with CPs, clinical pathways, but they're focused on the ability to save money to balance income and expenses. Early in the 90s, Dr. Kellett, who is a gastroenterologist, he started with the term fast track. That is not that we want to kick the patient out on the first day. It's to improve all the conditions for the patients to get a safer rehabilitation and to go out and reduce the length of hospitalization for at least 5 to 3 days at that time. So they evolved, and they evolved to the anorak, who is now that is in use in Denmark. They are the pioneers in Europe about fast-track surgery. So it's universal. They admitted all patients for joint replacement surgery. It was based on continuing high quality of treatment, nursing, and training. It was primarily based on decreasing from 5 days to 3 days the hospitalization. But now on this day, they got 20% of outpatient surgery. Patients must experience as little pain as possible, gain quick ambulation recovery, high patient satisfaction, and fewer complications than in the past. And most important of all, it must be based in evidence interventions. So our rationale was to enhance postoperative recovery, decrease morbidity and mortality, decrease convalescence time, and shorten the length of hospital stay. And these are the pillars of the Australian model. We had three main models. We got a preoperative checking and interventions to improve the medical status of the patients, intraoperative and postoperative interventions. And most important of all, we always need to check what we have done with the same aim. So hospital stay, morbidity, safety, cost, and patient satisfaction. So we give to all the patients a written and oral information 7 days before surgery. If you do it before that, 1 month, 2 months, they will forget about your indications. We check all the comorbidities and the nutritional status. And we elaborated a fast track to get referrals to internal medicine doctors, because sometimes it's very hard to get a referral for this patient, for these doctors. We stopped the opioids intake, and if the patient was more than 1 or 2 months, we referred to a pain management unit without in the same facility. Smoking cessation, we check the patients with psychiatric disorders, and we ask to the psychiatric if they're in drugs to make a pass to get the surgery done. We refer the patients, all the patients that got anemia, less than 10 milligrams per deciliter of hemoglobin, and the admission was on the same day of surgery. So, spinal anesthesia, no urinary catheter, local infiltration, tranexamic acid, and megadoses of dexamethasone. And in the postoperative, the most important issue was that they have a physical therapy very early. They stand up on the same day of the surgery, and they exercise for at least 3 days, 2 days. So one of the aims was not to see the hospital as a resort for old people. We want them to work, to stand up every day, and to get activity. But easier, they're old people. They got their traditions. So all patients between 2015 and 2017 were scheduled to leave on day two. The discharge criteria was pain controlled by oral medications, moderate pain. The patient and their relatives must accept discharge, and they got to fulfill some functional tasks. Get in and out of from bed, get into and up from the chair, get on and off of the toilet, and walk properly at least 70 meters. Oral and written indications to patients and relatives were given at the discharge. And we see from this work from Manu that all the interventions that we do in the preoperative, intraoperative, or postoperative have a result in decreasing the rate of comorbidities and complications. So we find that our results were very good. Total knee replacements, comparing with the 2013 results, the patients left the hospital at 2 days in 92% of the cases. UKA, 80% of the patients leave the hospital at the same day. We have no transfusion. We fulfilled the discharge criteria 96% of the patients. So why is the gap? Because there were some logistical issues that the patient wanted to keep in the hospital at least for 1 day more. Just 2 readmissions in the 30 days, 1 revision for infected knee, and 2 manipulations. So every act got a consequence. So we reduced the length of hospital stay in 37 hours in all our cases. We got a lower rate of complications, readmissions, and those early interventions reduced the final cost of the procedure by 25%. So we got a good platform to deal with the hospital. So we increased our surgical fees by 20% in 2 years. Why? Because we share the risks and the savings of this fast-track strategy. We signed a contract with the National Health System in 2018 to reduce the waiting list in TKA, so there are more than 200 surgeries per year for 2 surgeons. So we 2 surgeons are different referrals for private insurance company, just with the work of 2 years, decreasing the number of complications and decreasing the length of hospital stay. So enhanced rehabilitation programs must consider local characteristics of your population, hospitals and health policies to have an impact. This is not a copy-paste. You must know your population and act according to your people. It's an opportunity for surgeons to manage these programs and not to be just a spectator of the show. Fast-track protocols have reduced complications, morbidity, and length of stay, with a significantly decrease on expenses and cost containment of the procedure. Thank you.